in boxing.
And that's funny because when they called for the sparring, they said, hey, you got anybody this?
What music are you playing?
My son, and they said, your little son?
Yeah, no, I'm here for a run. I'm going to sell my punch.
Coach. You know, Virgil Ortiz listens to heavy metal and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. Virgil actually, like, is talented. You know,
he can play the piano. Did you know him growing up at all? I mean, he's younger.
No, I mean, yeah, we you know, we grew up always, you know, seeing each other at the Silver Gloves over there in McKinney, Texas.
He's special.
No, yeah, very, man. But he's, you know, a great fighter. And I'm also being very proud of, you know, everything he has been able to accomplish. And, but yeah, no, man, me and Virgil have known each other since we were kids. We never fought in the amateurs. We were never in the...
Okay, if you could have a punk band, what would be the name of it?
If I could have a punk band?
Punk band with Virgil. Virgil Ortiz and Mario Barrios.
Take
them
over.
The Aztecs?
I don't
because he always has the Aztec calendar on his trunk.
Yeah, yeah, I've seen that, man. It's beautiful, boy.
The
Aztecs. I don't know, bro.
Okay, Mario, he doesn't have a nickname. What nickname do you guys give Virgil Ortiz if you have to give him a nickname?
Man, it took me like 15 fights to like create my own nickname. I can't create like his.
The Executioner.
The Executioner? There is one already. That's Bihad.
That's true. See, that's hard trying to think of an original.
I was going to say Lights Out. He's 17 or 17 knockouts, but that was James Toney.
Oh, yeah, no kidding. See, there's always something. That's one of my reasons for picking El Azteca. You know,
it's unique. I've never heard anyone nicknamed the Aztec. You ever look at the pictures of the Aztecs in the encyclopedia?
Yeah.
If you look profile, Mario, I see a resemblance. Yeah. You get that a lot?
I'm getting that since I was a kid, bro.
You see? Yeah. You know what I'm talking about with the helmet and the...
Yeah.
he's the Aztec slash El Gallo Negro.
There is... No, that's Gerald Washington. That's his nickname.
No, Paco Aguilar, El Gallo Negro from Blood and Blood Out.
What's the band? The band. Do you play? The name?
The one I'm playing right now? Alright, that was casualties. But man, this is my funk playlist.
You got it. Thank you for doing this, Mario.
Oh, man. I need to warm up anyways.
Gotta watch them dance. Kid mouth out with dope, hello.
Who was that, Ricky?
Yeah.
You fucked him up?
Yeah.
Boy, I'm shooting. I got my jump rope. I'm like, dude, this jump rope is short.
Well, we got him fights. Oh, I got my son there. He's kid. They've got a lot of fights. He's only 14. And they go, your little son? And they ain't so little.
You're not going to snack? You're just training here?
No, yeah. I've still been going across the bridge to snack. I've been getting a lot of my recovery over there. And shout out to Snack Systems. They always take care of me, man.
Mike and everybody?
Yeah, all of them, man.
Was that the Russian guy? I forgot his name.
Remy Korchenko.
Yeah.
And Remy, you know, Tyler Victor Conti, man. Everybody, you know, Team Snack. They've been a huge, you know, part of my success, you know, in this sport. And I'm very thankful for them.
Like
mid? Not really. But I love doing the mid with Virgil though. said, man, Virgil's a very cerebral coach. The things that we have worked on the mitts, there you go. I haven't done mitts with anybody quite how I've done mitts with Virgil.
How did you team up with him?
After the title eliminator I had at 130, and we got connected through our manager, Luis Cuba Jr. But pretty much I said, you know, we looked at that fight I had with Dennis Bochero, and there's a lot of things I need to tighten up, you know, to be a world champion. And that was around the time my manager knew the style that I fought. He knew the style Virgil taught. And he had scheduled me to come out here for a week. No, just 1 week, just to see if you know, I like being out here with Virg. If Virg like working with me. And that 1 week, man, mine and Virg's style, it meshed very, very well. You know, Virg is not one of those coaches who's gonna be yelling at you. You know, who's gonna be trying to be on top of you all the time. Yeah, this is what you want to do. You gotta show them every time you walk through that door. And you know, since then, man, we have built a very great relationship. You know, in the gym and outside the gym. And I've been very, you know, very, very grateful for Virgil.
Grateful?
Man, I was like pouring out of me the whole time, man. I was thinking this poor guy.
No, you're good, man.
No, I don't.